Hello, math students. This is Ms. Jacobs. We're looking at 8.6, describing pairs of angles. And our essential question is, how can you describe angle pair relationships and use these descriptions to find angle measures? So, a couple of things that we've learned about angles in general. Let's just write this down. We've learned, number one, that angles can be right. If you look closely, there's four angles there that are all 90 degrees, right? So this angle here would be a right angle. The other type of angle you could have is something that's less than. Well, and I want to make sure that we know that right angles, the sum of these, not the sum, but the angle measure of a right angle is 90 degrees. So let's take a good look. We now know too, based on our previous examples, that if you have an angle that's less than 90 degrees, say this is 30 degrees, that would be acute. We also know that there are angles that are larger than 90 degrees. And then we have an angle that's called straight angle. And that angle measures 180 degrees. So those are some of the concepts. Make some sense? Let's use some of these concepts to describe these angles that we're trying to find. So find angle measures. Work with a partner. The five-pointed star has a regular pentagon at its center. What do you notice about the following angle pairs? So we have angle pairs XY, YZ, and XZ. So let's look at X and Y. So what do we notice about the angle pairs? All right, well, let's take a look. What do I notice about the pair of angles X and Y? It's the first angle pair I want to look at. And that we use red. There's X and Y. This is Y. And this is X. Well, those two pairs of angles, first of all, are next to each other. It's called adjacent. And then you notice that they form a straight angle. Again, if you look at this line, that's a straight angle. And so these pairs of angles live on a straight line. And so it appears that the sum of those two angles would be 180 degrees. So I'm going to write that. I'm going to say X and Y are adjacent. That means they're next to each other. They share a common side. Are adjacent angles whose sum is 180 degrees. And that hopefully makes some sense. How about Y and Z? The same concept. Angles Y and angle Z are linear pairs. That's another name for them. They're called linear pairs. One second, guys, my phone went off here. I checked something. Let's see. Okay. So, just a package was delivered. Sorry for stepping away. Now, Y and Z, same idea. Take a look. Choose a different color scheme. Purple. Those two angles. Look like they're adjacent, whose sum is 180. Okay, Y and Z. Take that. Go copy. Click here, paste. And finally, X and Z. Now let's make some room here. X and Z look different. What do I notice about X and Z? Well, if I look closely, let's take a look. They're opposite each other, I guess, or across. It's a tough way of understanding the concept, but they look like they're congruent to each other, that they have the same measure. So there's a special name for those, and they're called vertical angles. Now I'm going to write something along the lines that they are congruent angles who share a common vertex. But no common sides. So X and Z are congruent angles who share a common vertex but no common sides. Now let's try to find the angle measures. It says do not use a protractor. So we're going to find X, Y, Z, W, and V. All right, I'm going to move quickly because I'm almost out of time. Here we go. So let's find these angle measures. So we know that a linear pair or a straight line has 180 degrees. So here's what I know. If a straight line has 180 degrees, then we know that 108 is 108 plus x has to equal 180 degrees. So using angle addition, we know that 108 plus x must equal 180 degrees because those two angles form a straight angle. Take a look. Straight angle, right? Right. So we have that. So based on our mathematics, you can subtract that and you're going to end up with x equals 72. Make sense? So x is 72 degrees. So I'm going to erase that, make some room. This is 72 degrees. All right. Now we learned too just recently that this is also a straight angle here, right? 108 again, so Z must also be 72. All right, cool. See the pattern here? (Clears throat) And this is also a straight angle here. See it? It's pretty sloppy. And so 72 plus some number is 180. So we can tell that this angle must be 108. Keep going. So what about this angle called V and this other angle called W? Alrighty, so how can we find that? Well, there's a slight strategy here. Maybe you see it, maybe you don't, but I'll bring it up. So we have a regular pentagon, has six sides. So a pentagon, if it's regular, has congruent sides and congruent angles. So this is 108 degrees here. This is 108. This is 108. This is 108. And that's 108. So all of the angles and all of the sides must be congruent. Well, again, strategy. We now know that this is 108. This is a straight line here. So if this is 108, then the other side must be 72, because 108 plus 72 is 180 degrees. So this is 72 as well. All right? So I just figured out this angle here is 72 degrees. And finally, we know that this is a triangle. And the sum of the angles in a triangle is 180 degrees. So now what we can conclude is that 72 plus V has to be 180. That's the rule in a triangle. And so we end up with 144 plus V equals 180. So 44, 54, 64, 74, 36. 36 degrees. Let's take all that info and write it down. So X was 72. Y is 108. Z is 72. W and V, 72, 36. Explain how you obtained each answer. I did when I was doing it. So I'm not gonna recite what I did. But hey, I hope that helps. Another way of doing this, guys, would be to use, it says not to use a protractor, but if you really wanted to see all this play out, you can draw this out with GeoGebra and get a really cool looking picture, measure the angles, and then verify what we did, okay? So pause the video at sections to understand what's going on and give yourself some time to write this down. But that's exploration number one. Hope that helps. Like I always say, study hard and learn a lot. We will see you soon. Bye-bye.